I feel the need to have to do this review video because I love Alicia Keys' Girl on Fire album. I usually do reviews. I didn't do one for the Element of Freedom and somebody asked me why I didn't. So, hey, here's one. I know for a fact that people on my timeline asked Alicia about a classical instrumental for the opening intro of her album. And she gave it to us. She loves us, so, you know. She usually gives us what we want because we're spoiled as fam. Alicia Keys released Girl on Fire November 27th. So I hope y'all have it. I listened to the album a week ago when she had the Google YouTube Hangout. And if you go check the video out, I am one of the special fans who got selected to be part of the video on the Hangout. So that was a great experience, and here we go. The intro, the classical intro, I love it. It's just so peaceful and... So thank you, Alicia, for giving us this intro. It's a tradition, so, you know, it wasn't too hard to pass up. Brand New Me. I heard Brand New Me when she performed it on TV and at the iTunes Festival, and I instantly fell in love with it the first time I heard it because I was like, finally, Alicia is telling everybody, like, shut up. I'm gonna do what I wanna do, and either you like it or you don't. And if you don't like it, bye. But if you're an Alicia Keys fan, then I'm pretty sure that you know, like, what she's trying to say. You know all the media attention she's been getting. And if you're not an Alicia Keys fan, then I guess I don't have to explain it to you either. Because it really doesn't matter. But I like the build up. When it's all over. If this song don't make you want to dance, then something wrong. And I can't help you. But if you want to see, you know, my true reactions, you can always go check out the Google Hangout video because I was getting it. This is cute. It's like at the end of my life, long as I know I got to love you, then there's no other worries. Pretty nice. Listen to your heart. You know. Oh, this song reminds me of Sade. I don't know if it reminds you of her, but it reminds me of her. And when I instantly heard it, I was like, ooh. Definitely old school. Listen. New Day. At first, when I heard this song, I thought it was a joke. I was like, I know this isn't a single. But now that it's on the album, I kind of feel why it's on the album because all the other songs are kind of mellow, kind of passionate. And I guess New Day along with Girl on Fire, I don't know why this version is on there. Most of Alicia Keys fans is like Nicki Minaj on a classic album, why? But these two songs, I think, help lift the spirit of the album. So you don't be all sappy. Fire We Make, Maxwell. It's been a long time coming. We all been waiting for Alicia Keys' Maxwell song. Let's just start off hot. Fire We Make. So I just hope them two tour together, so that was another stream moment at Alicia and Maxwell when they tour together. Tears Always Win. I love the groove of this song, but I also love like her singing and stuff, like she's getting it all. It kind of reminds me of, it's Bed from the Element of Freedom. Well, Sheets were missing him at first, but now it's the lips. Not Even a King. This is another song that I fell in love with when I first heard her perform it. And my dog is escaping. Some people so poor on the thing that is money. This song is truly the truth. Like, everything about it is just true. Like, I don't need anything else in the world. Like, your love is priceless. And then I like the title, Not Even a King, because a king is like the leader of the world, but not everybody that's with him is loyal to him. But in her words, she's saying, like, the king can't afford our love. Loyalty. That's when I knew. Wedding song. I know it's going to be on some wedding playlist. My daddy busting at my dog. Definitely weather. Limitless, which is not a word, just like reckless love, but we're not gonna discuss that. It's Alicia Keys. She can name her songs whatever she wants. This is another song that makes me dance. Reminds me of the other song that she made. One Thing. This is a song I love, and I love Frank Ocean. I love his ability to write music, write stories, and that's exactly what he did on this song. It just opens up cold, like, oh, like, how did I get here? And then she goes into deep thought about just the journey. But I like the end when she's just passionate side of the song. I'm trying to get to it. I don't know exactly what part of the song is in. When she's like, I need a pick me up. That song. There we go. Right here. Definitely was my favorite song when I heard it on Google Plus Hangout. That was the one that struck me the most. It's almost haunting because you know exactly what she's talking about in it. And the fact that she was able to open up that way with Emily, it was shocking, honestly. I never thought I would see that side of Alicia, to be 100% honest. But at the same time, it's like a love-hate relationship with this song because it's so great, but it hurts. It really does, because you just know she's talking about Swizz. You can't deny it. But yeah, my favorite songs off this album are definitely 101, One Thing, Not Even a King, Fire We Make, Girl on Fire, Blue Light, but it's not on this album, Brand New Me, and probably Limitless. But I don't know. I like the whole album, but I'm pretty sure the songs that will not change for my favorite will be 101 and One Thing and Brand New Me and Not Even a King. Yeah. But how about that deluxe album? Hopefully. Alright, that's about it. Oh, this shit scares me at the end of this song. When I first was listening to it, I just was chilling, and then all of a sudden it just came on and it scared the hell out of me. I was like, what the fuck? Sounds like Illuminati kind of shit. Alright, y'all.